Honourable Member for Vanimore Green.
Mr. Deputy Speaker, me like Parliament to take note long statement long Minister of Foreign Affairs propose ratification by government. Me like make him some debate on top of this statement, Mr. Deputy Speaker.
Go ahead, Honourable Member.
Mr. Deputy Speaker, me am a mass long paper, Minister of Foreign Affairs, and me carry me come. Me tin also in this paper, you may need to look at low end good before government and me ratify him. Me also member of Vanimore Green River, me serve him common border. When the Indonesia, me looking at me got some serious issues. Government blame me the Papua New Guinea need to address him past time. Before you may ratify in this paper. Now, Mr. Deputy Speaker, you got plenty of security issues and missed up. You got plenty of cross-border issues and missed up. You may not get current paper, nothing come to Parliament just to ratify. And more important issues and be concerning to the country. Papua New Guinea is probably the only country within our region that shares the common border with a populous Muslim population of more than 330 million people. As such, Mr. Deputy Speaker, we need to be really careful on how we address the issues with our neighbor. While we respect them, I say this with due respect, Mr. Deputy Speaker, there's a lot of cross-border issues. And let me go on some of the issues that we need to really address as a country. Number one, Mr. Deputy Speaker, you mean as a country we have not been seriously looking at the border demarcation, whether it's the responsibility of the foreign affairs or the provincial affairs, we have not really addressed it. Why you pining most of the time you go to the border, Indonesians have already crossed into Papua New Guinea side of the border. They already engaged in activities into our side, and we have turned a blind eye on them encroaching into our side of the border. Our soldiers are no longer patrolling the border. Before there used to be a cross patrol on the border with police and the defense. It's not happening. Let's take, for example, in the mouth of River Torasi in Western Province. Indonesians have built their naval base within the waters of Papua New Guinea. And we have raised no issue on this. We have raised no issue on this. Why are we so silent? We go to the Wutong border. Papua New Guineans have been pushed to the edge of Wutong border when our land actually stretches all the way to the River Tami. And we have allowed Indonesians to cross over to our side of the border, building the infrastructure on the border, now we call Batas. They should be operating on the other side of the River Tami. The river should be used as a natural demarcation between the two countries. The land that stretches from Wutong to Tami belongs to the people of Wutong. They are Papua New Guineans, Mr. Deputy Speaker. They are Papua New Guineans. And most of our resource, Mr. Deputy Speaker, lies within this land. Oil and gas, gold and copper. When are we going to raise these issues? Every time a border liaison meeting is held, we are taking our people to Jakarta. When they go to get Jakarta, they go and drink beer bitter, they go and do illegal activities, then they don't go and attend the border liaison meeting representing our country. Mr. Deputy Speaker, this is a serious national issue. This is a serious security issue. We need to carefully look at these treaties before we bring them to Parliament to get it signed. Do we know what's happening on the border? More than 12,000 citizens from West Sipik, especially in my electorate and the electorate in Telefomin, have crossed over to Indonesia. Because we on our side, as a national government, we are not providing the basic services to the people living along the border. So, Mr. Deputy Speaker, I want to have a look at this treaty before government passes it and have it rectified. And I am arguing now as the chairman for Defense and Foreign Affairs and International Trade, Permanent Parliamentary Committee chairman. I want to have a look at it before it's rectified. I want to raise the issues of our land. Why has Indonesia encroached into our side of the border? We need to raise these issues. It's high time. Maybe we should close the Batas center in Wutong and have the Indonesians move to the other side of the river, River Tami. Maybe we should now look at what's happening in river, the naval base that's been built in the River Torasi, at the mouth of River Torasi in Western Province, and ask the Indonesians to dismantle that naval base and move it to the side of the waters. We must make hard decisions and hard stand. We are a sovereign nation. We cannot go and conduct border liaison meeting all the time in Jakarta. They get our officers drunk, give them women, and then next day they are drunk, sitting there and just say, yes, sir, yes, sir. I am proposing that every border liaison meeting should be held outside of Indonesia and Papua New Guinea, somewhere neutral, so we can raise these issues. These are important sovereign issues. We cannot turn a blind eye on this. Mr. Deputy Speaker, I propose that this particular treaty be withheld. Allow my committee, as the Permanent Parliamentary Committee on Defense, Foreign Affairs and Trade, to review it before we actually sign it. Thank you, Mr. Deputy Speaker.